There's a lot of hype about AI in design, but most of these allow you to type what you want in text and then they generate the image. Almost all of them don't work properly with text. So if you ask them to include some text in the generated image, it usually doesn't work at all. So this is where the new Adobe Firefly is different. Firefly does have an image generator, but it also has a dedicated text effects generator. Go to Adobe Firefly. As of now, it is beta. Create or use your existing Adobe ID and then ask for the beta rights. There are many things there, one of which is text effects. Before you do anything, just look at all of the existing effects, hover on a image, and then it'll tell you what is the prompt. You can see how beautiful text can be created with the desired fill. Really, essentially, it's a fill, right? There are only two things you can do here. Type the base text and then type what do you want. So I'm going to say art as the text and then blank canvas. It gives you four variations. You can try them out. Now, of course, this has nothing to do with blank canvas. God knows what it understood out of it. But whatever it is, the output looks beautiful. Now, usually, what are you going to do with that text? You're going to put it somewhere else. That's why, by default, the background is transparent. What do you do with this? Well, you can download it. Or if you quickly want it in clipboard, just say copy to clipboard. And if you want your creation to be visible to the world, submit to Firefly Gallery. When you download it or copy paste it, you'll notice that there is a watermark. Now, this is because, as per the terms and conditions, this is not to be used for commercial purposes. I simply crop it and that should be okay. If there is any legal risk, that's yours. Now let's go back and look at the nuances. First of all, if there is a mistake, you can improve that AI by saying this is not what I asked for. So when I say thumbs down, someone is going to look at that and say, oh, I asked for blank canvas and this came, that was wrong. So they will try to improve it. Now let's look at the effects available. 27 effects, nature, materials, and food and drink. But it's very important to click okay on each one of them initially, at least so that you know what you're going to get, because this thumbnail is not a very representative thing. The second thing is text fit. So loose will have more spillover, medium is the default, and tight is what I usually use. Then there are fonts. Of course, Adobe has a huge collection of fonts, but here you have only 12. And finally, you have control over the color. Usually you will take background as, but if you want, you can put a specific color. At this point of time, they're very limited colors and you can't put your own color. This is a great way of creating good looking, attractive, impactful text with very little effort. Imagination is the only limit. Nowadays, there is a lot of hype about AI. I also have a video about how to use Bing Chat and how is it better than ChatGPT. Have a look at that video as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.